Winston Edmondson here with Studio B. I'm going to have a chat with Jadeep Sudhabar about Cisco's latest offerings. Jadeep, what do you got going on?
So we have two major products being launched at EMC World, the MDS9710 and an MDS9250i. Both these change the way SANs are done, in the sense that the MDS family has now brought performance to the next level. It does three times the performance of anything on Earth. Basically, it does 24 terabits per second per chassis, 1.5 terabits per slot, which is unheard of in this world. So, and the MDS9250i does multi-service. It's a multi-service switch that does FCIP extensions at 10 gig, if you like. And it's got 40 ports of 16 gig FC. 8 ports of 10 gig FCOE, so it's a different product completely.
Impressive stats. Now, this is breaking news. You're just launching this right now at EMC World.
Yes, absolutely.
Good deal.
Now, and EMC announced support as well yesterday, so we're done. Perfect.
So it's already a winning product. Tell us a little bit about the evolution. What got us to here?
Sure. So we had requirements in the past. Like if you think 10 years ago, SANs were built to support storage networking, and that's it. Requirements have grown, and at that time we had something called the MDS9500 series, which still continues to sell very well. It works perfectly fine. But the requirements have evolved in the sense that if you think about virtualization and what that has done, there's more and more compute being packed in a physical server, which means there is more virtual machines that are being packed into that. Also, storage arrays are growing. The type of data that we use is growing significantly. We have statistics that say it's going to grow by 10x by 2020. So with so much of storage growth and so much of virtualization growth, you need a bigger, fatter pipe that is super reliable. Since you have so many things in a physical server and so much of storage stuff, you need something that's super reliable and super powerful. And that's what the MDS family is designed for. The current chassis, although we've taken out the first offering is a 16 gig product, it is built for 32 gig and 40 gig FCOE already. And nothing says we can't change the fabric card in the back to support 100 gig FCOE.
Wow.
So that's what's changing, and that's why the products have been evolving over time in some ways.
Give us some scenarios of customers where this would be the solution that they've been waiting for. Tell us what customers would really benefit from a solution like this.
Sure. So at this point, there is not enough of usage of the 16 gig links. I can't imagine some customer, except for ISLs or ICL links, depending on who you talk with, you're not going to see too much of usage of that. What we're building for, though, is for the future. And that today, if you're using an 8 gig link, it's fine. It should work perfectly fine for the next 2 years, 3 years. But you don't know when it's going to change. And you might as well be prepared. You might as well do investment protection, buying the next generation of chassis up. And in terms of cost, it's almost similar. So there's no reason to stop at the 9500 series. You would need 9700. It's kind of, you know, you would get the latest and greatest thing.
So what you're telling me is this is a beast that probably no one could really utilize it to the fullest extent. But for folks that are investing right now,
yes,
why not go ahead and get this? So kind of to future-proof their investment.
Absolutely. And then, like I said, it's built for future-proofing. It's built to support the next 10 years or more of evolution of the SAN. And it supports FC and FCOE. So it allows you to migrate if you want to. It's a mix and match product. So you could put all FC if you like, and you can continue that down that route. Or if you wanted to transform to FCOE, you could do that too. So it allows you to do both, go both ways.
Pretty exciting. You know, a lot of CIOs are looking for that future-proof investment. They don't want to have to rebuild or completely redo something that they just bought right now. So here's your best option. Tell me a little bit about EMC World. I see you've got a booth where, if we can pan and kind of take a look, it's standing room only. You've got the audience sitting down, but then it overflowed. And what are you guys talking about that has so many people involved, excited, and willing to stand up and wait in line?
So architectures. We build fantastic boxes, but we also come out with bigger, larger architectures that support whatever you're trying to do in the data center. We help you design your data center so that it's cleanly done. You're thinking of every single component as well as the bigger picture. And you're thinking about workloads they're changing a lot these days. And since we talk with so many technology companies, we do know what's going on in some ways. We can come up with best practices, and we share those best practices on Cisco.com as well as at trade shows like this. And that's what people are looking for.
This is school, basically. Everyone's sitting here to...
Workflow. there's not enough space.
So, you know, unfortunately, if you missed this opportunity at getting a good education, how about some resources online? Where else can people learn some of these options that we're discussing?
Yeah. So cisco.com/go/MDS. That's the main site. And if you go there, you'll get links to everything that we're talking about over here.
Fantastic.
Go/MDS. Okay.
Fantastic. Winston Edmondson here with Jadeep, checking out for Studio B. We'll talk to you soon.